Hello and welcome on behalf of GanitSora.com. As you know, GanitSora.com is a very popular mathematical website, and I am also associated with GanitSora. I'm a part of the editorial team, and last October I had started a series of articles under the name Simple Concept Tough Problem. Okay, so to basically deal with problems that require very basic mathematical concepts but seem quite difficult to solve. Okay, so today I'll be considering the problem of one problem that was asked in PRMO 2018. So as you can see on the screen, how many six digit numbers of the form ABC CBA are divisible by 7? Okay, this was the question. Not exactly this, there was some modification. Let us have a look. There was this part, if B is odd, okay, the question that came in PRMO had one extra condition that B is odd. So let us consider both the things. If if there is no restriction on B, how to solve it? If there is restriction on B, how to solve it? Okay, so first let us try simplifying the things a bit. Assume that we have already learned congruences. Okay, assume we have already learned congruences and observe that in the expanded notation, ABC CBA can be written as what? 1 0 0 0 0 0 A, right? Plus 10,000 B, 1000 C, 100 C, 10 B plus A. Okay, this is the expanded notation, and so we can just simplify this. Can be written as this times A. Let's take the A's and B's together like that, and then this will be congruent to 6. The first one will be congruent to 6 modulo 7. The second one, this 10010, this will be congruent to 0 modulo 7, and the last one will be congruent to 1 modulo 7. Okay, so those who are new to this congruence, you can just try showing this. This quantity is congruent to 6 modulo 7. That means if I divide this number by 7, the remainder is 6. Okay, or this minus 6 is divisible by 7. Okay, that's the thing. So ultimately, the given number is congruent to C minus A modulo 7. Okay, so our problem reduces to finding the digits C and A, or finding the number of all possibilities for the digits C and A, such that 7 divides C minus A. Okay, so thus 7 divides ABC CBA equivalently means that 7 divides C minus A. So observe that the digit B doesn't matter. B can be anything. Okay, only what matters is 7 should divide C minus A, right? So now C and A are digits, so we just need to find all possible C and A for which 7 divides C minus A. So you can keep on trying. So there are some hints, so of course I'll discuss the solution as well. So one example is, say I take A as 7 and C as 0. So you have numbers like 710017, 720027. Okay, how many such type of numbers you can form? So that is the approach to the problem. So let us see it in detail. So the problem reduces to finding the digits A and C such that 7 divides C minus A, or equivalently 7 divides A minus C. Okay, so note that the value of B doesn't matter, right? So with the example given above, for A equal to 7, C equal to 0, we can have 10 numbers. Okay, how we can have 10 numbers? Because for B there are 10 options, right? B can be any of the 10 digits, 0, 1, 2, up to n. 0, 1, 2, up to 9. So you can have a look at these numbers: 7, 0, 0, 0, 0, 7, 7, 1, 0, 0, 1, 7. Okay, that way 7, 9, 0, 0, 9, 7. These are the numbers with A equal to 7, C equal to 0, right? So in the same way, we need to find all the possibilities, but we will not list all the elements this time. Okay, we will use a simpler technique of the principle of counting. Okay, principles of counting to find how many such numbers are possible. Okay, Before that, observe that 7 divides C minus A is same as saying 7 divides A minus C, right, by property of divisibility. So the values chosen for A and C can be interchanged to get another possibility. That means, say if I get a value as A equal to 8, C equal to 1, okay, interchange the values, that is A equal to 1 and C equal to 8, that is also a, that also corresponds to a, one of the solutions. Okay, that is what I am saying. And so keeping this in mind, we can list the possibilities in a tabular form. Okay, say A and AC, the first column AC or CA, that is A can be 0, C can be 7, or A can be 7, C can be 0, the other way. Okay, but in the first case, A cannot be 0 because A is the first digit of the number. If A is 0, then the number is not of 6 digits. I need a 6 digit number. So in the first case, there is only one option. A has to be 7, C has to be 0. B can be any of the 10 digits, right? So how many options are there for AC? There is only one option for AC. A is 7, C is 0, okay? But there are 10 options for B. So total, in this case, there are how many numbers we can form? 1 into 10. Right, that is the multiplication rule of counting. For each choice of A and C, there are 10 choices of B. Okay, that is why the number of numbers that can be formed is 1 into 10. Next is A can be 1, C can be 8, or A can be 8, C can be 1. Okay, so there are two possibilities. Here you see options for A and C. There are two options. One is A is 1, C is 8. Another option is A is 8, C is 1, okay? And for each such option, there are 10 options for B, okay? So number of numbers is 2 into 10, that is 20, okay? Then similarly, A can be 2, C can be 9, or the other way around, A can be 9, C can be 2, okay? So there are two options for A and C, right? And there is only, for each choice of A and C, there are 10 choices for B, right? So the number of numbers that can be formed is 2 into 10. Any other possibility? Can A be 3 and C be 10? That is not possible because A and C are digits. Okay, so they have to be lying between 0 and 9. Okay, but another possibility we have, A and C can be equal. Okay, when A and C are equal, A minus C is 0, so 7 divides that. Okay. So this is one possibility. So in this situation, how many options are there for choosing AC? A and C, they can be chosen in 9 ways. Okay, because A and C are equal, and 0 cannot be A, right? A cannot be 0, the first digit cannot be 0. So there are 9 options. Okay, it's like 11, 22, 33, 44, like that, up to 99. So these are the 9 options. And for each such option, choice of A and C, there are 10 choices for the digit B. Okay, so total there are 90 such numbers where A and C are equal. Okay, so if you add them up, there are 140 such numbers. Okay, now come to the second part. If B is odd, then the number of options, how many options will be there? So it's very simple. If B is odd, then the number of options for B will be 5 instead of 10. Okay, so the number of such numbers will be what? It will be just 1 into 5 plus 2 into 5 plus 2 into 5 plus 9 into 5, that comes out to be 70. Okay, so this is the answer. If B is odd, there are 70 such numbers which are divisible by 7. Okay, so here you have seen the concepts that we have used, the concept of congruences, right? A is congruent to B modulo like this. Here A is congruent to B modulo 7. Okay, what does it mean? It means that 7 divides A minus B. Okay, this concept we have used, and some properties of congruences, and we have used the multiplication rule of counting. Right, if an object or if a job can be done in P ways, and for each way of doing that job, another job can be done in Q ways, then both the jobs can be done together in P into Q ways. Okay, that is the multiplication rule of counting. Okay, of counting. and we have also used the addition rule of counting. Okay, addition principle of counting. Okay, we have if we have two disjoint sets, then the number of elements in the union is the sum of the number of elements in the individual sets. Okay, so these three things that we have used to solve this particular problem. Okay, right. So I hope it is clear to the viewers. So I'll be back with another such problem which require basic mathematical skills. Till then, thanks.